Let's talk about this overall database security section by looking at something we've already worked with. Let's look at the point builder and the security there, because it's very similar. See, what we saw in earlier videos when we were talking about interfaces being able to write to the interface tags using these identities, I showed you that this data security section within a point attribute, this is how we control who has access to write to this. In this case, I created an identity. That identity is being used by this OPC interface when it connects. So because that identity has read-write access to the data that's associated with this tag, then that means it can write values to that interface plus the other tags here. Now that's how we control who has access to edit tags, to write values to tags. Okay. If you take a look at our database security, it's very, very similar. If we go into PyPoint, this is how we control who has access to create points in the first place. Okay. Now, this is kind of at a macro level. The individual point security controls who has access to points. This controls who has access to the point database in general. So, for example, I will not be able to create points in this PyPoint database if I don't have read-write access here. Now, by default, what you'll normally see is you'll normally see this behavior right here. PyAdmin and PyAdmins, this is a Py user and a Py group, they both have read-write access, and PyWorld has read access. Now what this means is, well, first of all, it means that when I'm working within the local computer here on the Py server itself, since when I log in, you know, locally, I am logged in immediately as PyAdmin with complete permission to do everything, you know, this means basically I have free run to be able to create things when I'm doing this locally. But remember, that's only for people who are logged into this computer. When I log into this computer, the local Py server, then I get connected as PyAdmin. When you want to do something remotely, you're going to need something better than that. You need something to create an identity that has permissions, because you don't want to be logging in as PyAdmin or in the PyAdmins group. We suggest you use Windows Integrated Security for remote access. And for that, you'll need to create an identity. And now this goes the same for other tables as well. I just showed you the PyPoint table because it's a good starting point, but if I want to control access to who can create other identities, I do that through the PyUser table, and it has the same configuration. The modules in the module database, you know, that's all done through this table here, and on through these tables that are, you know, that are described in your book. Anyway, in order to give people access to this, I'll need to create some kind of an identity and then make sure that that identity has read-write access. So one of the things I can do is, let's look at our existing identities. Yeah, let me just designate one of these. I'm going to say anybody who logs in as a supervisor who is mapped to this identity called PySupervisor, we want them to be able to have read-write access. Now currently, I've got a few Windows users who are mapped. Here's the one that I'd like to show you right now. It's a user named Sal. He's in the domain called Virtual Labs, and he is mapped to this Py identity called PySoup. Well, what permission does that give him with regard to the point database? Well, absolutely nothing, because if we take a look here, PySoup's not mentioned here. So first of all, I would have to add this user add PySoup as an identity, and then I'd have to grant that identity some privileges. I'll go ahead and add. And then the next thing I'd have to do is I'd have to make sure that that identity has read-write access. So I'll go ahead and say read-write access to that PyPoint database. Now that should, you know, by the, you know, benefit of having done that right now, that should give Sal the ability to create Py tags. Let's demonstrate that. First of all, let's remove that ability. I'll go ahead and just give them read access. And I'm going to go ahead and log on to my remote node here, and I'm going to log on to this PySMT, the system management tools. Let's log on as Sal. So I'll go into this, I'll do a right click while holding down shift on here. I think I have to hold down shift to do a run as. Let me see. It looks like you can just right click on that, choose the run as, and I'm going to run this as the Windows user called Sal. So I'm choosing to run this not as who I'm currently logged in as. Now this user, he's in the domain called Virtual Labs, and his name was Sal. Go ahead and type in his password. and that should log me into the PI System Management Tools as the user Sal. I can verify that by going into Connections. I can attempt to do a connect, and as you can see, it has now connected me as that user called Sal. So let's see what happens when I try to build some new points. If I go into the Points section, into the Point Builder, and I've already got, or let me go ahead and select that. I forgot to select my server first. Now, I already have three tags that are getting their data from the OPC interface. Let's say I want to create a fourth tag. Okay, yeah, so here are some three tags here. I've got pump speed, test, etc. I want to add a new tag called, I'll just call it test 2. So the easiest way to add a new tag is to just go into an existing tag, and let me go ahead and just rename it. I'm not going to change anything. Everything else looks good. And now watch what happens when I try to save this. I attempt to save it, and right now it's saying, giving me this failed to create point. It's giving me the infamous -10401 error. Very, very common error. We see this all the time. It's basically indicating that we're trying to write to something, but we don't have permission to do that. So how can I give myself permission? Well, let me go back to the server, to the home node. And on the server, let's give Sal, by way of his mapping to this identity, let's give Sal write access. I'll go ahead and specify write access to the PI Point database. Let me go back to my remote node. And since I haven't tested this first, this ought to be a moment of high drama. I'll go ahead and try saving. And let's see, did it work correctly? Yes, there we go. So it successfully created that PI Point, as I expected it to. And the reason I was able to do that is now Sal, by way of his membership or his mapping to that identity, and because that identity now has read-write access to the PI Point database, now he can create tags. What we've been discussing so far is how to give somebody the ability to create new tags. Well, watch what happens if I remove Sal's read-write access or write access from that Point database. You'll notice, even though he doesn't have the ability now to create tags, if I were to try to create a tag now, he would not have that ability. Okay. Even though I've not given him access to that, the only thing he would need to edit existing tags is if we go into the points themselves and then designate Sal or Pi Soup, you know, and therefore Sal, and designate Pi Soup having read-write access to this data. So let me demonstrate. See, I'll go ahead and just verify now that we've successfully hobbled Sal so that he no longer has read-write access. If I go ahead and try saving this as pump test or pump speed test 3, let's see what happens when I try to save. Yeah, see, now we're getting that same error again. And so we've successfully disallowed him to be able to write to that. But watch, if I were to, you know, working as PI admin now, because I'm back on the server, as PI admin, I can go ahead and make PI Soup somebody who has read-write access. So I'll go ahead and add PI Soup to this existing tag. And then I will give PI Soup write access. I'll make sure I save this tag. So now this pump flow here, as you can see, unlike the other two tags here, pump flow now in its point security has PI Soup having write access. What this means is that I should be able to go back into my other machine using Sal and be able to edit this pump flow. So let me go in and see if I can change the descriptor now. I'll go back into my remote node here. Yeah, here's my pump flow. Now remember, I'm logged in as Sal, and Sal did not have permission to create. I'll just change this, and I'll go ahead and try to save. Now right now, the error message says, cannot write to that. I'll go ahead and save. And it looks like it was successfully edited. And if I go back to my home node, if we refresh this screen, we should see. Yeah, see, that edit did work. So that's the one point I wanted to make. It's a kind of a subtlety, but what it means is that when you're working within this database, if you want to grant somebody access to edit existing points, you don't need to do anything for him here. The fact that he has you know, he has the permissions of PI World means he has read access to the point database. As long as he has read access to that and then read write access here, as long as that's the situation, he will be able to edit existing tags. But when it comes to creating new tags, for creating new tags then, or new modules or new users, etc., he would be required to have read write access here. And that would go ahead and grant him permission to build brand new tags.